welcome in studio this hour as a friend of Bill, a fellow talk show host, radio talk show host, Mark Levine. Hey, Mark, good to see you.
Hey, good to be here.
How'd you make it all the way in through Hurricane Sandy? You had a special FEMA escort or something?
You know, it was easy. I'm sorry. I feel bad for all the sufferings going on in New York and New Jersey, but I don't think we were hit that bad here in D.C. I lost my power for maybe 2 minutes, and then it came right back on, and the streets were as empty as they could be. I'm used to a Tuesday morning rush hour. This was nothing coming in here. No. I was the only one on the road.
Well, there's nobody on the road. The federal government has shut down, I believe, isn't it, all for the second day?
Yes,
yeah,
it
because
is.
The metro is shut down again. National Airport, Dulles, both shut down. No flights. Amtrak is shut down. So, and in New York, same thing with the subway. They got more serious problems up there because the subway is flooded.
There's some flooding, right?
And we have the regular team here this morning, Peter Ogburn and Dan Henning. Hello, guys.
Hey, hey.
Good morning.
Cyprian Bolding, our videographer, on the cameras, and Phil Backert on the phones. Now, Peter Ogburn is without power, so you have to be
forgive me if I stab you in the neck with a pen for showing up here with power.
A little sensitive here.
Sorry. No, but like 3 months ago in July, that was a bad storm. I mean, for people in D.C.
The derecho.
It was really hot. It was 100 degrees. You lose your air conditioning. I was out of
trees
power
all over the place.
For 3 days, the trees were blocking all kinds of roads. I got to say, compared to that one, this one isn't as bad, at least not for us.
Yeah. No, I had power during that. Cyprian, he was without power for 5 days during that event, which is brutal.
Yeah, that one was a lot worse. And I remember, I've been here long enough to remember 10 years ago, Hurricane Isabel. Remember that? We had flooding like almost to my house. It was like the river, Potomac River, like came within feet of my house. So this is nothing.
Alexandria almost went under.
That's
right?
True. Actually, it did. Parts of Old Town were absolutely underwater.
Yeah. But for the most part, Washington, D.C., it was just a long rainstorm, which I guess is still raining outside. Don't know.
It was when we came in
this morning. All kinds of impacts of this storm. New York, particularly hard hit. New Jersey, Long Island, bore the brunt of it. And you think about many different impacts. One is New York City's entertainment industry was pretty hard hit, including the David Letterman show.
Oh, I thought you were going somewhere else with that, Bill.
No, which had to go out last. No, but they had to go on last night without a key factor to the David Letterman show. Here's how it started. How the opening of the show sounded. Audience applause. There's no audience. They didn't have any audience because nobody could, New York is shut down. Nobody could get there. So they went on. David Letterman.
You gotta have cabs, right? No?
Fewer cabs. And you try to get one.
I guess,
All the people who might have been in the subway, right? So they had no audience. And so David Letterman and Paul Schaefer, they try a few jokes without an audience. You would know, it doesn't really work. Here they are.
So here are the jokes. If we had had an audience, here, let's run through some of these jokes, Paul.
Yeah.
I come out and I say, well, so much for the drought. That would have been the opening.
That would have been a funny opening. Right there.
It's a whole different perspective when you're sitting here reading them.
Well, there's no, you don't get any reaction.
No. That's about right. I got up this morning, turned on the radio, and listened for the talk show closings. I have no luck.
Talk show closings. That's a play on.
Wait a minute. I think I hear people banging at the door of the theater, demanding to come in. Wait a minute. Yeah. We don't want to miss this.
I love that.
They need a laugh track. So funny. Just push the button.
Right. Yeah. They've got laugh tracks, or they have applause tracks. Too,
the weirdness of that is so funny. I love it.
I know. Well, I know what he feels like. I was listening to the talk show closings the last two mornings. Yes. And I didn't hear a full court press. I heard the Italian grammar school and the Potomac K through 12 or the Alexandria Middle School. I didn't hear the full court press on the list. Okay, so again, Mark Levine's here as a friend of Bill this whole hour. Chris Geidner from BuzzFeed will be joining us a little bit later, and we'll check on how we did weather the storm with Jason Samenow from the Washington Post. He's part of their Capital Weather Gang. But first,
This Mark Dan is always the has full the big court
headlines.
Press.
Other headlines making news on this Tuesday. Anderson Cooper is down a job. The CNN host's daytime syndicated talk show has been canceled. It will not return next year after the second season wraps in the spring. New York Times reports the cancellation, obviously because of low ratings. Anderson released a statement saying he was proud of the work that he and his staff did for two seasons.
I got to say, I like Anderson Cooper. I'm not surprised. You know,
no, I'm not
I think
surprised.
He does a really good job at 360
he's
Anderson Cooper.
He's a good serious reporter. He's not an Oprah, you know, fluff
it
guy.
It seemed like such a good idea.
Well, we said at the time it wasn't going to work,
of
right?
course. Yeah. Saw that coming from a mile away.
Hey, Levi Johnston.
Square peg in a round hole.
Yeah.
Levi Johnston got married. Bristol Palin's ex exchanged vows with Sonny Oglesby, the mother of his 2-month-old daughter, Breeze Beretta. Man. Inside Edition reports Levi wanted his and Bristol's 4-year-old son, Tripp, to be the ring bearer at the wedding, but Bristol would not allow Tripp to go to the ceremony. And to make it clear that he's not a Sarah Palin fan, Levi yesterday said he is leaning towards voting for Obama.
Did he really?
I love it.
How perfect.
Hey, wait a minute. Now, was Sarah Palin invited?
I don't think so.
Hell no.
Not if the kid couldn't come. Yeah. Yeah.
I'm sure he wore a very nice sleeveless camouflage tuxedo to the wedding.
God. And out in Hollywood.
And for the wedding meal, they had a moose that he shot.
Yeah, but let's keep gay people from getting married. Yeah, let's let him get married and keep gay people from getting married. God.
Out in Hollywood, one of Tom Cruise's neighbors had a bit too much to drink. He tried climbing the fence surrounding the actor's home. LA Times tells us one of the actor's security guards tasered the neighbor, held him until police arrived. He was arrested. Yeah, Cruz was not home at the time. The guard did not know it was a neighbor at the time. He's just shot before
otherwise
looking.
Otherwise, he wouldn't have tasered him.
Yeah, probably.
Good thing he wasn't wearing a hoodie and living in Florida.
Really. Oh, God. Man, I'll tell you. All right, so there you go. Thank you, Dan. Indeed. Well, Mark, we've had this curious intersection, which we've been exploring this morning, between... So 1 week to go, right? And everybody's saying, oh, the October surprise. What's the October surprise going to be? It turns out the October surprise is Hurricane Sandy.
There you go.
Right? And there's a real intersection between the storm and the election in many ways. I mean, events had to be canceled. Both Obama and Romney have canceled 2 days of events. Early voting suspended. Some polling places may not be able to open. A lot of people without power. The network news, right, is not focusing on the election. People tune in, right? Last night was 1 hour of storm coverage on all the networks. They expanded, not talking about the election at all. So, who do you think this helps, and who do you think it hurts?
I think it helps President Obama.
Because
first of all, remember, Mitt Romney wanted to abolish FEMA. Now, of course, he's flip-flopped on that recently, like everything else. Mitt Romney 19.0 says that now he wouldn't abolish FEMA, but of course, just 6 months ago when he was being severely conservative in the nomination battle, he said in debate he wanted to transfer that to the states. I wonder how the little state of Delaware would deal with all the devastation that they're suffering right now.
Well, I wonder how any state would. I mean,
right.
Here, in fact, absolutely. Dan, let's get Chris Christie, bring him in here. Very seldom do we give Chris Christie a role on current TV, right, or our progressive talk radio. But this was, as you say, the president, in touch with every one of the governors.
Mm-hmm. As he should
red
be.
Red states and blue states.
As he should be.
Helping them out.
Right.
And Chris Christie, to, I'm sure, Mitt Romney's dying regret, had some good things to say about the president. Here he is.
So I appreciate that call from the president. It was very proactive, and I appreciate that type of leadership, and I appreciate the president's telephone call. And if we do need something, I've got the number, and I'll be sure to use it.
I appreciate that type of leadership. So
wow.
It does show Obama in the role of commander-in-chief of the
It also shows that Chris Christie's running for president in 2016. If Romney wins, he'll run for re-election. Christie does better, actually, if Obama wins. Okay. I'm not saying that that's the reason Christie said
conspiracy theorist.
I'm not saying that. I'm just suggesting it without saying it, see?
Yeah.
Just a few moments ago, by the way, speaking of Christie, he actually tweeted, I want to thank the president personally for all of his assistance as we recover from the storm. Yeah. He's making a great case for Obama as commander-in-chief.
And what was was it he just said on one of the other?
I have to pull it up, okay. But he basically said Obama's doing a great job, excellent job, and thanked him for all of his help.
We have to just compare President Obama, obviously, with President Bush during Hurricane Katrina, who was out to lunch, and of course, Brownie was not doing a heck of a job. That was, of course, Michael Brown, the head of FEMA at the time, who was busy eating a very expensive meal and couldn't be bothered with something like, you know, 1,000 people dying in New Orleans.
All right, which gets to what I think is, you put your finger on what I think is the biggest impact of Sandy on this election.
A reminder that the government can work, and the federal government often does some very good things.
And a reminder, the New York Times headline this morning of their lead editorial is, "A big storm requires big government."
There you go.
I mean, it's so basic. And yet here's Mitt Romney, who was saying not just would he give Medicaid back to the states, not just give anything to do with education back to the states, not just give Medicare to the private sector, right? You get a voucher and then
I call it a coupon. 10% off.
You have to deal with the private insurance companies.
Right.
Everything, the auto industry. No, the federal government's not going to help. We'll let private sector take care of that. But even when it comes to disaster relief, he is actually saying, no, get rid of FEMA, no federal role, just let the states, no federal money either, just let the states, 50 different states do it 50 different ways.
When Republicans want to abolish spending, they say let the states do it.
Yeah.
Okay, it doesn't matter whether it's Medicaid, nursing homes, whether it's FEMA, whatever it is. They say, oh, no, we'll get it done. We'll just have the states do it.
Right.
Why do they want the states to do it? First of all, the states don't have near the tax income the federal government does. They can't fund near the program the way the federal government does. And also, state legislatures are often much more easily bought by corporations than the federal government. Look, many people do happen to know they're a member of Congress. Many don't. But far fewer Americans know the names of their state legislators. I ask people listening to us right now, can you name your state legislature? I hope you, I hope you can, in the Assembly and in the Senate. Most Americans can't, and that means that they're under the control of groups like ALEC, groups that are funded by big corporations.
Absolutely.
They have a lot more control, and therefore they can put the arsenic in the river, you know, don't let the EPA around.
But
transferring to the states is Republican code word for abolishing the program.
Of course it is. And then you think about, after a storm like this, the roads that have to be rebuilt, the businesses that have to have some help so they can get back open again. I mean, the transportation systems on and on. The trees have got to be cleared. I mean, the beaches that have to be replenished.
The metro and the subway are publicly funded.
All of that. And imagine the states or the cities' ability to do that without federal funding. Impossible.
Of course it is.
Which just shows you how dangerous. So to me, this sums up what this election is all about.
That's right.
That President Obama's understands the important role of government in certain areas, not always,
and you know,
not
it,
everything. And Mitt Romney doesn't understand at all that there is a positive role of government.
And there are people that pretend that government is easy. There are people that pretend,
evil.
Well, no, but any president could easily help disaster aid. Well, all you have to do is compare Obama with George Bush, right? Compare his FEMA with George Bush's FEMA. Compare that with Bill Clinton's FEMA, which did a very good job in the 90s with Hurricane Andrew and so forth. You know, if you don't believe in government, you're less likely to run it well.
First one, Bill Clinton, first one to make it a cabinet agency. Absolutely. Yeah, didn't we learn anything from Katrina? Didn't we learn anything?
I would hope so,
too. Hey, join the conversation here anytime. We'll save a seat at the table for you at 866-55-PRESS. Send us your comments on Twitter, too, at VP Show. And Peter will check with the comments when we come right back here on the Full Court Press. Tuesday,
chatting
October
with
30.
You live.